Hello everyone, my name is Shai Sharon and I'm a surgeon scientist. Today I would like to walk you through my workflow for reading and writing manuscripts. Before we start, in the description section down below you'll find the link leading to this Notion page, which includes all the links, videos, and other information that I refer to during this video. Okay, so let's get started. Whenever I want to find manuscripts, I don't go to PubMed and use a search term and then go in the list and waste time in that process. Instead, I have an app. It's an RSS feed app called Inoreader. This app automatically downloads manuscripts for me from PubMed according to predefined rule, meaning I don't need to do anything for it. I just get up in the morning, go on the Inoreader feed on my phone or on my computer. The feed looks like this. This is my actual feed of head and neck cancer. And these are the manuscripts published on PubMed on the last few hours. Okay, and if you scroll down, you will see more and more manuscripts. When I want to keep up to date, I just go into this feed and I can click any manuscript I want. Inside this app, inside the Inoreader app, I'm not on PubMed right now, I can read the abstract itself, and everything appears on my phone as well and syncs between my devices. And if I want to read the entire manuscript, all I need to do is click the PubMed ID and then it opens up the manuscript itself. So this is how I find the manuscripts themselves. In the video, in the description down below, again, you'll find the link. So the first section of this Notion page explains about the literature search. Here you'll find a video that will walk you through all the steps needed in order to set up a similar feed on your computer, on your phone, according, of course, to your terms, your search terms on PubMed. So we got to the stage of actually reading the manuscripts. And because I don't want to violate any copyright issues, I'll just use my own manuscript. So this is the manuscript that I want to read right now. So we can go into the manuscript itself. Now, what most of us do in this stage is download the article, download the PDF, and then go on and read the PDF itself. So how does it look if we want to read the PDF itself? It looks terrible, okay? This is just awful. How can you read a manuscript on your screen this way? Imagine opening up a manuscript on your phone, okay? So of course you can zoom in and you can get rid of this and this, and then you can read, and when you get to the bottom, or you can zoom in like this, and when you get to the bottom, you go up like this and continue reading. This is just an awful way to read manuscript. We just gotten used to it so much that just assume this is how it should be. So I don't work this way. I don't use PDF for reading at all. I use PDF for sharing and that's it. So instead, what I do, whenever I stumble upon a manuscript that I want to read, what I do is hit the Readwise Reader button here, okay, the Readwise Reader app, and then it is imported into my Readwise Reader app. Okay, in this Readwise Reader app, this is how the manuscript looks. Okay, much, much, much better. Of course, we can get rid of the panes here. And I can define how I want the manuscript to appear on my screen. I want bigger font size. I want more spacing. I want to have narrow or wider appearance on my screen. Okay. In the manuscript itself, I can highlight, and these highlights will be downloaded onto my Readwise Reader account. I'm not going to go into all these details. In the description down below, we'll walk you through all the steps, but this is how I read manuscripts, okay? Much more enjoyable. Compare it to just going in, zooming in and out. If you want to look closer, you just need to zoom in and out. You can't do what I did right now while I use the Reader app, okay? And this is how I read the manuscripts when I want to consume them, highlight, and then get rid of them. But if I want to keep it, the next step is to use Notion. So I go back into the manuscript. I can open up using each one of these links. And once I open the link itself to the entire manuscript, I just select everything, Control A or Command A on a Mac. I copy it, Command C on a Mac or Control C on a Windows computer. And then I go into my Notion app and just paste the manuscript. Now, the way it's going to be pasted, it's not very comfortable or as fun to read as in the Readwise Reader app. Some of you may say, I prefer to just read the PDF or read it online. That's fine. But the reason I imported by copy-pasting the manuscript inside my Notion was not to actually read the manuscript. Although, of course, I can read it here. And again, when I pasted it here, it is also synced onto my phone and other devices. But what I really like about the Notion part of importing manuscript is the AI capability. You have the button here for the AI, and then I can ask the document questions, which is really, really nice. I can ask the document, what is the link between radiotherapy and head and neck cancer? Now, unlike ChatGPT that uses information it was trained on, information from the internet, you can never know where this information came from. Here in Notion AI, it just uses the information inside my Notion, just the manuscripts and the information that I imported into Notion. So let's see. I asked it the question. Now it thinks. Now it searches my Notion database and answers my question. Now this answer is based on the information I imported. This is not an information just from anywhere in the internet. This is not just information ChatGPT sometimes makes up, okay? This is information that I rely on. And the nice thing here is that with this answer, I also got links. So it shows me where this information came from. For example, I'll just click the one here, and then it will go into my Notion database and show me the manuscript from which it brought the answer from. This is really, really nice. And this is the Notion AI feature. Now, inside the Readwise Reader app, I also have GPT capabilities, okay, AI capabilities. With here, currently, as of the time of filming this video, the GPT is GPT 3.5. If you're watching this video at a later time, it might be GPT 4, 4.5, etc., etc. But it can summarize the document. It can also perform AI, artificial intelligence functions on this specific document, okay? Just on this specific document. And again, here we're inside the Readwise Reader app. I can ask the document a question again. What is the link between radiotherapy and head and neck cancer? If you're not following right now and inside the Readwise Reader app. Before that, I demonstrated the AI capabilities of Notion, but these are the two apps I'm using. And right now, the answer to this question will be based upon this specific document, okay? I can also summarize the document. I can also generate thought-provoking questions. What are the new players in immunotherapy and targeted therapy for head and neck cancer? How does immunogenic radiation impact the effectiveness, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera? So we're not going to, of course, go into all the details of this document, but this is a great, great, a wonderful tool for lab meetings, for sitting with your students, with your colleagues, because it will generate AI responses, AI questions, based on the information you provided. So this is something, as a scientist, I can rely on. I never use AI to write stuff, okay? And in the link down below, I also have a guide and description on how I use AI for research. I use it for summarization, for generating questions. I'm not using AI to replace me as the innovator. I want to have the novelty. I don't want the average responses of ChatGPT. Okay, so these are the Readwise Reader and the Notion. And if you go again to the link in the description down below, you will see the links and a full guide how I use Readwise Reader. And next up, I want to touch on how I use Notion in order to write reviews or to review the literature. So for that, I prepared a whole separate video. Again, inside the link down below, you will find this document that has a link to the YouTube video, how I made referencing automatic and productive. So when I import documents, manuscripts into Notion, for example, this is the actual table that I used when I wrote the review I showed you here inside Reader, okay? So this is the table that I used when I wrote this manuscript. So I'm not going to go into all the details. Again, in the video, you can find all the details and you can learn how to set up this table on your own computers. But this is just a walkthrough to show you how I worked. So for example, if right now I want to write a paragraph that summarizes all the phase one trials, including SBRT, this is just a type of radiotherapy, then I can see all the documents here, okay? If, for example, right now I want to use not SBRT in phase one, right now I'm writing a paragraph on the phase two trials. So here are all the phase two clinical trials, okay? And I want to include just the clinical trials which included the metastatic setting, for example. So here, out of my entire list, I'm only seeing the manuscripts having these specific topics in them. And now I can go one by one and decide whether or not to insert it into my review. I can also see the bottom line here. I can see when this manuscript was published. And I can also open up the abstract itself. This abstract is inside my Notion. I didn't even leave Notion here and go into PubMed. I'm retaining my focus and everything is done inside Notion. I can read the abstract, and then if I decide to go and read this specific manuscript, I can just click the link here and read the entire manuscript. So this is how I work when I review the literature and when I write manuscripts. This is great for review manuscripts. It is also great for the discussion section and also for the introduction. Okay, so this is how I use Notion. And again, in the description down below, you'll find links, in this case, a link to the video in which I show how to link Zotero. This is the referencing app I'm using, how I link Zotero to Notion using the Notero add-on. So this is how I use Notion to review and write manuscripts. So this is pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.